All right, hello everyone, another class on ionic equilibrium, and in this class, this video, we'll talk about a very peculiar solution. We'll talk about buffer solutions, buffer compounds. The term buffer literally means protection, and we'll see in chemistry, these compounds, such chemical compositions, would provide a unique protection against the change of pH, even on adding strong acid, strong base, such that all the pH sensitive reactions could be carried out very comfortably without any hassle. Now naturally, most of the physiological reactions, metabolic reactions, even in our syllabus some reactions you will learn are pH sensitive. And if some acid or base is produced or absorbed in those reactions, the pH will change and the reaction would stop. Imagine hundreds and thousands of reactions happening in our body, human body. And the common fluid, the common connecting tissue, human blood, traveling to different organs. In stomach, where gastric juice, HCl, and the medium is very acidic. In different organs, the pH would be different certainly because of the type of chemical reactions happening there. There's a buffer of carbonate and bicarbonate in human blood. So that human blood, you know, moving in all different organs, different parts of the body, can support all reactions happening because there's a carbonate bicarbonate buffer protecting a change in pH. So the role of pH, the role of buffer is to provide a medium where all such pH sensitive reactions could be carried out. We'll want to begin with the way it's introduced in most of the textbooks. It's supposed to be a solution having reserved acidity or basicity. Reserved means something which is hidden, which will come in use in a crisis, like the Reserve Bank of India or the reserve fat in a body. So it's supposed to be a solution having reserved, hidden acidity or basicity, which can counter a strong acid or base and control the change in pH. And again, it's supposed to be a solution which resists a change in pH. So I'm going to begin with these two formal definitions. It's a solution having reserved acidity or basicity, a solution having reserved acidity or basicity, or it's a solution which resists a change in pH. A solution which resists a change in pH even on adding small amount of strong acid or strong base. On adding small amount of strong acid or strong base. In our syllabus, the two types of buffer are an acidic buffer, which is a mixture of a weak acid and it's salt with a strong base. Any day, the popular choice of weak acid is acetic acid. So acetic acid, you know, will dissociate in this manner. And considering this strong base as NaOH, the salt being sodium acetate, a strong electrolyte. Salt is always a strong electrolyte. I tell you, there is nothing like sodium acetate in water. It's sodium and acetate. Ye pura dissociate karega. Bohot acetate milega. Isko bolte hai common end effect. Ye mixture lene ka objective hi hai ki is equilibrium ka product bohot badha do, jisse ye equilibrium aur piche aa jaye. It was a weak acid to begin with. It ionizes to a small extent. Recall Lichaclier's principle, product badhane se equilibrium aur piche aa jayega. Aur iska mixture ka matlab hi hai, you want an equilibria of a reversible weak acid where you have a lot of product and a lot of reactant. I repeat, it's called common end effect, which is basically if a strong and a weak electrolyte have an ion in common, the ionization of the weak electrolyte, in this case the weak acid, is further suppressed. It is a weak acid ionizing very little, and if it is further suppressed, this means basically it's not ionizing. You have a lot of acetic acid because you have a lot of acetate, because you have added a source of acetate, which is sodium acetate. Now, one thought which can hit your mind right away is, you have a mixture of acetic acid and acetate, both reactant and product of this equilibrium. You can sense adding H plus will move this equilibrium back, and naturally adding OH minus will move this equilibrium forward. If adding H plus moves it back, which is acetate becoming acetic acid, adding OH minus will move this equilibrium forward. So basically, if some acid or base is added to it, the equilibrium will move backward or forward, and that H plus or OH minus will be neutralized. This could be an initial thought. The objective of taking this mixture is, when you look at this mixture, you have a lot of acetic acid and a lot of acetate. So some H plus coming from an acid, this equilibrium will move back, and OH minus from a base, the equilibrium will move forward. Basically, the equilibrium will move forward backward, and the amount of H plus or OH minus from a strong acid or a strong base will be neutralized. That is how the buffer might be working. We'll talk about it in more details, but this is one type of buffer. The other type of buffer is a basic buffer. The other type of buffer is a basic buffer, which will be a mixture of a weak base and its salt with a strong acid. So let's take up a basic buffer. A mixture of a weak base and its salt with a strong acid. So naturally, the choice of the weak base, common weak base, is ammonium hydroxide, giving NH4 plus and OH minus, weak, reversible, double headed arrow. And strong acid could be HCl, ammonium chloride, ionizing completely a lot of NH4 plus. अगेन कॉमन एन इफेक्ट. देर इज नथिंग लाइक अमोनियम क्लोराइड इन वाटर. पानी में अमोनियम क्लोराइड बोल के कुछ नहीं होता. अमोनियम होता है और क्लोराइड होता है. सॉल्ट पूरा आयनाइज करता है. इस इक्विलिब्रियम का प्रोडक्ट मिलेगा. ये इक्विलिब्रियम पीछे आएगा. ये पहले कम आयनाइज कर रहा था. यू हैव अ लॉट ऑफ प्रोडक्ट एज वेल एज रिएक्टेंट. दिस इज अगेन एन एग्जाम्पल ऑफ कॉमन एन इफेक्ट. एंड द इनिशियल थॉट सर्टेनली कैन बी, adding OH minus will convert this to this, adding H plus will convert this to this. You know, when a student learns from first principle, nothing has to be mugged up. The only problem is the textbook will not speak this language. The textbook does not speak to you. It's after spending time with the subject, a very close analysis, thought process like this would generate, and eventually we'll see the same happening. This is how this will be neutralizing OH minus and H plus coming from a base and an acid respectively. But you know, we'll want to spread it out, we'll want to see it in more details. But this is the composition of an acidic buffer, this is the composition of a basic buffer. You'll want to copy all of this at your convenience, and then we'll want to talk about the pH which has to be controlled. We'll want to see how to calculate that pH. You'll want to copy all of this at your convenience. We'll want to begin with acidic buffer. And if it's a mixture of these two, we'll see how to calculate that pH. Naturally, we'll want to begin with this weak acid. Like any equilibrium constant, it will be written like product upon reactant. This will be acetate. Square bracket means molarity. Product by reactant. Simple cross multiplication. H plus will be Ka into acetic acid upon acetate. This is cross multiplication. And now, you take minus log on both sides. Minus log of H plus will be like minus log of Ka minus log of acetic acid upon acetate. This will be the pH. Minus log of Ka will be written as pKa. You will prefer a positive instead of negative, so this negative will be made positive and the ratio will be inverted. You will want to write it as log of acetate upon acetic acid. And in general, you will write pH is equal to pKa plus log of
salt by acid. In general, you will want to write this as the equation giving you the pH of an acidic buffer. Now, depending upon the pH required, you will want to choose the corresponding acid, the corresponding pKa value, and keep the composition of the salt and acid. Remember, you will believe all of acetate is coming from the salt. You will believe all of acetate is coming from the salt because this is practically non-ionizing. And you will want to choose the acid and the composition such that the required pH or the desired pH is arrived. With a given composition of an acid and its salt and the Ka value known, this is how you will want to calculate the pH, and this is called Henderson's equation. It's very popularly called Henderson's equation, which gives you a formula to calculate the pH of an acidic or a basic buffer. Now, how does this buffer work? How this pH is maintained? I've already given you an idea. H plus will convert this to this. OH minus will drive this equilibrium forward. Let's take it up in more details. How does this buffer work? So this will be like action of buffer. Obtaining Henderson equations would be fun. Nothing new, nothing peculiar. We begin with a normal acid ionization constant like we write for any ionization constant, very basic mathematics. So this is how you derive for Henderson equation. And how does this buffer work? Action of buffer. How does this buffer work? On adding H plus, expect acetate to become acetic acid. And on adding OH minus, expect acetic acid to react with OH minus to form acetate plus water. It's written in a symbolic manner in most of the textbooks. This is a kind of symbolic representation in most of the textbooks. I think this is very clearly understood. Acetate would neutralize H plus, forming acetic acid. Acetic acid will neutralize OH minus, forming acetate. Only the ratio will change. And this is given in most of the textbooks. This is there in most of the textbooks. Although the two equations above narrate the same story, but this looks a little symbolic. So this cyclic symbolic representation will mean H plus will convert acetate to acetic acid, OH minus will convert acetic acid to acetate, and only the ratio will change. I've tried to explain it logically, I've tried to explain it mathematically, and now I'll give you a problem based on the same. The best way to understand things in physical chemistry is, you know, to solve problems on the same. I'll give you a real exam problem. A question which came in IITJ way back when it was a subjective exam, and chances are by solving a numerical, these ideas will get cemented, these ideas will get properly ensconced into your mind. But some things which you will want to always remember is, there is nothing new. We are approaching in the conventional manner of writing for the equilibrium constant. I'll talk about it at the end of the class again. This is how H plus and OH minus from an acid or a base will be neutralized. And then we'll see a problem, a question which came in the IITJ. You'll want to copy everything at your convenience, and you might have seen this question again. Suppose you are given a 1 liter mixture of 1 normal acetic acid, weak acid, and 1 molar acetate, sodium acetate. They'll give you the compound, maybe. They can write acetate or they can give you sodium acetate. You have to find its pH given Ka is equal to 1.8 into 10 to the power minus 5. For acetic acid, it's a very common value. I keep on saying, it's a very common value. 9 out of 10 times, this is the value which used to come in IITJ. It's a very common value. Now, even in the NEET exam, various engineering medical entrance exams, they have started endorsing this value.
It's a very common value. Good people will know the pKa value. 5 minus log 1.8 will see will be almost 4.74. So it's a very common value. You have to find the pH for this 1 liter mixture buffer. And then you have to find pH on adding. You have to find pH on adding 0.01 mole of HCl to it and 0.01 mole of NaOH to it. So there are three layers: initial pH calculation, then the pH on adding an acid, and the pH on adding a base. Suppose we want to calculate the initial pH, and the initial pH would be like pH is equal to pKa plus log of salt upon acid, Henderson equation. Now any day, the two are equal, this is 1 molar and this is also 1 molar, both are 1 molar, it's given in the problem. Both are 1 molar, so this will get evened out, log 1 is 0, and pH will be equal to pKa, which is minus log of 1.8 into 10 to the power minus 5. I repeat, good people will recall it, I'll repeat, good people will always know this, 5 minus log 1.8. is almost 4.74. It's 4.74. I'm limiting it to two steps. It's 4.7447. So this is the pH of the initial buffer. The pH of the buffer is 4.74. On adding HCl, part one of the problem. On adding HCl. Now HCl, you know, will convert acetate to acetic acid. It will convert acetate to acetic acid. You have 1 mole of this and 1 mole of this. To begin with, 0.01 mole of this means this will decrease by 0.01, this will increase by 0.01. Simple as it looks. So you have 1 mole of both to begin with. In 1 liter, 1 molar will mean 1 mole of both to begin with. 0.01 mole of H plus will react with 0.01 mole of acetate. So this will decrease by 0.01. and will form 0.01 mole of acetic acid, so this will increase by 0.01. The same Henderson equation, and this time the pH will be equal to pKa plus log of acetate. Now acetate now is 0.99. Acetate now is 0.99. Acetic acid is 1.01. This will mean it's a value slightly more than pKa. It will be a value slightly more than pKa. And once you put it down, calculate it, I'm sorry, it will be a value slightly less than pKa because 0.99 is less than 1.01. And you'll see the value will be almost 4.73. You're adding an acid and the pH is decreasing. But the change in pH is very, very small. It's the second place of decimal, 4.74 to 4.73 is very, very small. Imagine if you add the same acid to 1 liter water, if you add this to 1 liter water, neutral water, and the pH will change from 7 to 2. This is 10 to the power minus 2 molar. This is 10 to the power minus 2 molar in 1 liter water. So 10 to the power minus 2 molar, pH will be 2. From 7 to 2, it will be a change of 5 units. This will be a huge change in pH. The solution will become very acidic. So in normal water, the change in pH is 5 units. In this buffer, 1 liter, the change in pH is 0.01 for 4.74 to 4.73. This means the buffer is working. I told you what will change is the ratio only. That too guarded by a log function. Log of 1000 is only 3. So, you know, only the ratio will change, then the log function. You understand the chemistry behind it. You solve a problem, you see a real exam problem, you see the change in pH is so small. So you know the buffer is working. The change in pH is very, very small. Otherwise, in water, the change in pH would have been too much. We take up the second part of this problem. I can remove the question. We take up the second part of the problem. On adding 0.01 mole of NaOH. A strong base OH minus. The second part of the problem could be this OH minus will convert acetic acid to acetate, acetate plus water, and this was 1 mole to begin with. 0.01 of this will mean now this will decrease by 0.01, this will increase by 0.01, and the same Henderson equation, this time pH is equal to pKa plus log of, now acetate now is 1.01 and acid is 0.99. All this was understood in the principle of action of buffer. OH minus 0.01 will react with 0.01 mole of acetic acid, so this will decrease by 0.01 to form 0.01 mole of acetate, so this will increase by the same value, and this will be a value slightly more than pKa, and the increase would be the same as the decrease. You'll see this will be 4.75. It will be 4.75, the change would be very, very small, like the decrease was very small, the increase is very small. Yet again, if you add this much of NaOH, to 1 liter water, the pH would jump from or drop from 7 to 2, because 10 to the power minus 2 molar NaOH, POH will be 2 and pH will be, POH will be 2 and pH will be 12. So 7 to 12, 2 would be the POH, I'm sorry. POH would be 2, pH will be 12, 7 se 12 ho jayega, 5 units badhega, yahan pe jo badh raha hai wo 0.01 hai. So naturally the buffer is working, and I repeat, it must be understood in the best possible manner by solving a numerical. You see only the ratio is changing, and yes, the buffer is working. The change in pH is very, very small. Let's very quickly go past the Henderson equation of a basic buffer and its action, and you know that would be the end of this session in all likelihood. So you know, I would want you to read a good textbook as well. So many times, you know, you get too dependent upon a teacher. That should not be the case. So many ideas should come to you by reading and by learning of your own. Chances are, when it comes from me or a teacher, it's in a more refined manner. So many times you would want to learn things in a more cruder way. So now the basic buffer, which was a mixture of ammonium hydroxide and ammonium chloride, common an effect, a lot of ammonium and a lot of ammonium hydroxide. This would take care of OH minus, this would take care of H plus, would start running in your mind. And you begin with KB. Which, like any equilibrium constant, is product by reactant, cross multiplication will give you OH minus, taking minus log on both sides would eventually give you the Henderson equation. So minus log of OH minus will be equal to POH, minus log of KB will be equal to POH is equal to PKB plus log of, you'll want to change the ratio, ammonium upon ammonium hydroxide. And in general, again, it will be POH is equal to PKB plus log of salt upon base. This is again Henderson equation. And how does the buffer work? Action of buffer on adding an acid. H plus NH4OH with H plus will form NH4 plus plus water, and on adding OH minus, a strong base would give you OH minus. On adding a base, OH minus, certainly NH4 plus with OH minus would become NH4OH. This is the symbolic representation I keep on talking about. All textbooks would give you a cyclic representation like this. What changes is the ratio? and what changes to a very small extent is the POH or the pH. The best way to recall it is, look at this equilibrium, look at this equilibrium, this in a lot of amount, this in a lot of amount, and this is how you learn ionic equilibrium. You know, when you are given a solution, you want to know what are the species in the solution. When you know a buffer is going to fight against an acid or a base, what are the species that will fight with H plus or OH minus? Naturally, this equilibrium has a lot of ammonium hydroxide and a lot of ammonium. So this will fight with OH minus and this will fight with H plus. In the course, you know, they'll get interconverted because H plus will shift this equilibrium forward, OH minus will shift this equilibrium backward. Only the ratio will change, and this is how you learn ionic equilibrium. All of this topic, whenever a solution is given to you, you need to understand the species which are in abundance. When you prepare a mixture of these two, what you have in abundance is a lot of ammonium from ammonium chloride and a lot of ammonium hydroxide. And these are the soldiers which will fight with H plus OH minus and will control the POH or the pH of a solution. The same can be said for acetic acid and acetate, where a lot of acetate with H plus becomes acetic acid and a lot of acetic acid with OH minus becomes acetate. The more time you spend with these topics, it's important to read from textbooks, and eventually the ease with which you solve problems, problem solving, you know, would reflect your understanding of the topic. Chances are the understanding is going to grow with solving problems. We'll be doing that in the coming classes, but this much for the time being. Thank you so much.